What's up, everybody? This is Ron Carroll, the Minister of Sound. And you know what time it is. It is House Talk time once again. And trust me, we're excited to be here just for you in this corner. You know, weighing about 98 pounds from the city of Madison, Illinois, it's the one and only MonaLisa.
Hey, hey, hey.
Yeah. And in this corner, weighing about 387 pounds, he's from the west side of Chicago, West Side. It's the one and only Jamahl Sumrell. And me, I am your host and big teddy bear moderator. My name is Ron. I'm in the middle. So listen, this is House Talk, and we're very excited about today. We got a show talking about the quarantine, right? And so with the quarantine, we got to ask you a few questions. All right. Y'all ready, guys? Y'all ready to debate
I'm
this?
I'm ready.
Are y'all ready? Okay, y'all listening and y'all here, listen. How do y'all feel about hygiene during the quarantine? I mean, like, honestly, like, are you keeping yourself clean daily like normal? Or are you like, you know what? I can skip a few days. Nobody's around me. I'm locked in the house.
You know what? I'm going to be honest and I'm going to be real. If I wasn't married, I probably can skip a couple of days, and that's because I keep good hygiene. Only for good hygiene, right? Because, honey, you can smell yourself, okay? But because I'm married, honey, I can't afford it.
No, you cannot.
I got an old husband that want to hump every hour, so I got to stay fresh, okay? Come on, somebody. So for married people, you definitely should be keeping hygiene.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
you cannot
God.
Afford to. You got to stay fresh so you can be ready. At all times.
Come on, Lord.
Come on, somebody. What you got to say about that, Jay?
Well, it's been, you know, this quarantine thing has been kind of crazy, you know. But for me personally, I'm kind of bougie. So
you clean?
Every day. You know what I'm saying? I have to shower every day, some days twice a day. I can't play around
Ooh,
with that.
You real
squeaky.
Outside,
squeaky.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Hey, you know, you got to smell good. You still got to look good. You
do
still
you
have to go to the stove. You still got to be fresh.
Right?
You know what I mean? So that's
do
what it is.
Do you put powder on?
No, I don't put powder on.
Because you know they got that thing with Johnson & Johnson.
You have been
don't put on that.
Powder. And,
no.
and
exactly.
Powder. Call now. You can't put powder on them things down there.
No, you cannot.
And try to act like you didn't wash up.
No, you cannot.
That thing would get in your skin and you'll be on that commercial, okay?
Ooh,
you
got to
take it. So what about you, Ron? I mean, you as a big guy, talk about it.
Well, let me tell y'all something. Big men cannot go 2 hours.
<I cannot.
laughs> Understand what I'm coming from. Hallelujah, amen.
All right.
Big guys can't go 2 hours without it. So
hey,
I need you to always keep that thing fresh down there.
Yeah.
In both areas.
Yeah.
Right.
Don't think you could just squeeze a little water in the booty area and then the ball area you need to clean up. No. Clean up every area, soap and water.
Between me and thee.
Between me and D.
Come on.
Very hot water. Okay, scold it. Scold it.
Steam. Hey, plus that to make sure you don't get COVID is having a lot of steam showers. So I advise y'all to, you know what I'm saying, get on down.
That's kind of interesting.
A steam shower?
No, because steam does really help you. So if you haven't been taking showers, this is
the perfect time. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, no, I get it. I get it.
Exactly.
Yeah,
I mean, isn't it weird that you're washing your hands all day?
All day.
And then, like, the rest of your body is dirty. Isn't that weird?
Look, I saw somebody's arm. Baby, listen. I said, you ain't do nothing to that arm.
Baby, you kept it right.
It has light skin.
At the wrist. She kept it right at the wrist. I ain't going no further. The water stops here.
Fool.
At the wrist.
A fool.
But on the real, I mean, honestly, that's been a good question. I've been thinking, honestly, from watching on Facebook, I've been seeing some people's shirts. And, you know, I'm like, that ring around that old shirt, that dingy shirt, you could not have washed it today and put that dingy shirt on.
They might.
And came on live. And
they might have. They might have.
I don't believe you. You've been caught up. So this is something to tell you, okay?
Oh my
if
God.
You're going to be on live, you're going to do something, put a clean shirt on, even if you didn't wash up. Because you know we can tell. I was looking at one dude's shirt. I said, what? I mean, I kept up coming to my own screen phone. I was like, what is that on that neck?
Oh.
Baby, it was a ring of dirt. I said, caught up.
You better
now,
use some
I
extra.
Think, like I said, I think men, honestly, and that might be biased to say that, but I don't think some men. I think y'all going 2 or 3 days with them old.
It could be some brothers out there doing that, but that's on them. I can't even think about that like that. That sound bad.
He about
me.
To come for the women.
Like
look at him, y'all.
You know what? I'm not going to cause no problems on this show. Okay? I'm not going to do it.
Say it.
I'm not going to do it.
Say what's on your heart.
Listen, women, you all are inner. So you really.
You do.
Really.
You really.
Y'all really got to
be. I mean, you really.
On top of that. Like, because
it
real,
can go
real.
From beautiful.
Oh, my God.
To a fish market closed down.
To call the police.
Hey, it's been some people.
Instantly.
Call the police.
I've been riding to get away from them.
Right now. Hey, listen. I'm sorry. We got to keep it moving. We got a short show. We're about to go into our music break. Right here with Miguel Miggs featuring Pevin Everett. This song is called Love. We have. Let's go. Pevin Everett, Miguel Miggs joint.
Wow.
I like that. What y'all think of that one?
I was feeling that. I really was.
It's really good.
I can see myself cleaning up the house today.
Yeah. Yes.
It's a good vibe.
It's a good quarantine vibe. You're in the crib.
That was good vibe.
Yeah.
That was a good vibe.
The love we had, y'all. That's Miguel Miggs and Pevin Everett.
Very
listen,
nice.
We about to go to topic number 2. Let's get ready
to
debate.
Let's get it
topic
cracking.
Number 2. Are you ready?
Let's get it cracking.
Okay, all right. Now, we talked about, you know, quarantine hygiene. We talked about it.
Yeah.
You know, briefly. Mm-hmm. Now, what I've been really seeing from a lot of people is this quarantine relations.
Ooh.
Ooh, it's been life changing.
Baby.
Do you hear me?
Can I say something?
Come on, talk.
First of all, I'm thank God for quarantine right now. If I was single, this would be a perfect time. Women, if you don't understand, this is how you're going to really find your husband right now.
Oh, amen.
In the quarantine. A, you're going to find him because guess what you're doing right now? You about to hear his conversation. That's what you don't hear. You don't hear it in the club. You don't hear when they just meet you. Because I know when before I was single, even to now, people always meet me. How you doing? Can I take you out to eat? You don't even know me. You about to, matter of fact, let me take, come on. Take me out to eat so I can eat these appetizers and this nice little cocktail on and go home full to my other guy that I really want to kick it with. You silly. This is going to educate you men out here and women. See? You should be talking on the phone. We need to go back old school. Jamahl, bring us back to how old school
Oh, my God. She was ready for this one.
I was excited.
I'm right there with her because, you know, doing quarantine, I've been on a couple dates, right?
And, how was it?
The days was great, you know what I mean? You know, it's just, people are different during quarantine. I will say that. Just, they say one thing, but then it's total opposite of what they say, you know what I mean? So even getting to know them, do you really know them? You know what I'm saying? I'm a realist, so I don't sugarcoat anything. I don't do none of that. And you know, some people just use you for a meal or for drinks or whatever. You know what I'm saying?
I was a meal queen, honey. I ain't gonna lie. You probably know me now. I was the meal queen, was the sucker that went for it because you didn't have a conversation with me.
No. Hold on, because I have all the conversation in the world, my sister.
Okay.
You know what I mean? The problem is a lot of women out there can't keep up with my conversation.
Now, what you all about?
I'm all about loving self. I'm all about loving the world and all about unity. You know what I'm saying? In relationships in the past, you know, I'm one of those guys that give flowers still.
So,
you know what I'm saying? I'm old fashioned like
that. I'm with you on that. But can I say this?
Okay.
Can I say I'm with him on that? All I'm saying is at this moment, if your conversation can't keep a person, you have nothing no more. You can't
absolutely.
Even do Netflix and chill right now.
Smash. Oh, that's what they
said. I can't bring you to the house. I don't know if you got COVID or not.
Right.
Smash.
So right now, that phone conversation got to be lit.
Smash.
It's got to be old school.
Right.
It's got to be all day talking.
Right.
It's got to be going to sleep walking.
Yeah.
Smash.
Like I said, I'm with that because I really want to get to know a woman. You know what I'm saying? So I'm an amazing listener. So for me,
let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question. Mm-hmm. What if, now you know how I go. Mm-hmm. Some people meet you during quarantine.
Uh-huh.
They've been in the house.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and they're a little horny. You know, their little feathers is ruffling a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Because
I ain't going to lie. I'm a big dude, but I've been countered. I don't know what it is, but they've been coming up to me like, hey.
You ready?
I've been locked in.
Yeah,
this thing been locked down.
It's ready to come out.
And I'm ready to what? Smash, 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 smash.
So what are you saying?
Why are you a fool?
Are you saying that? What are you asking?
Well, here's the question. You know what? I like your face.
Right.
I love your face. What I'm asking though, Jamahl, what if they want to start out with the smash first and then go into the conversation?
I've heard that.
Sometimes it starts with the smash.
They do, but people want to test drive.
Right. Sometimes, you know, it just depends on the mood. Like, if you're in that kind of mood, then, you know, that'd be something you could jump down on. That's how I feel about it. I'm just in a different mindset for me right now.
We're
so.
Going to have to get him his own Bachelor show. Y'all ladies out there, it's just.
You know what? We're going to do what?
Jamahl. Hey, this is the perfect gentleman. He want to go on long walks and beach and talk.
I'm
he want to get you flowers. Out there. You ask them where he's at. Look right here.
Come on, right
have
here.
Have no fear. Right Jamahl here. Is here.
You know, we're going to do that. We're going to set for this show.
Okay.
We're going to set some girls up to come.
Right here.
What's that show? When they used to blindfold them.
Blind date.
We going to do it right here.
Love connection.
For
Jamahl, I want you to right now, if you are one of the women or if you have a cousin or auntie that should be in this situation and he's, listen, you got it. Jamahl, what's the age limit here? Because I don't want anybody calling you. I don't want nobody's grandma calling you.
Be careful.
What's your age?
I would say
15.
What?
Are you crazy? I say... 38 to 55.
Okay, that's a good range. 38 to 55.
Why not 60?
Now, you know at 38, they can still have kids. You still good for that?
Well, I don't
bring
know
it
about
up,
that.
Bring it up, nah. Bring it up, bring it up.
Nah, no
let's
kids.
Let's go with 42.
No
let's go with 42.
Me. I don't want to have to put my age out there, but nah.
So let's do 42. Let's do 42.
Oh, yeah, let's go 42.
42 fine. To 50, 50, what was it?
I'll go 56.
42 to 56. If you out there, I need you to comment right now. We're going to bring you in and see if we can bring a love connection in.
Okay, that sounds good.
You guys
that sounds
funny.
Good. I wish we can go further, but we run out of time on the topic. We'll come back with Suckers Need to Know in a minute. But here's our next music break. Chicago's own artist is Angel A and Rasol. It's called Your Best Life right here. House Talk. Let's get it. This is like I called in the Ashford and Simpson of Chicago. Like,
all right, come on,
Angel and Rasol.
I'm definitely feeling that.
Yeah,
for sure. It hit a sweet spot.
It's a feel-good song, man.
Yeah. It's called Your Best Life, guys. I think it's out on Track Source right now, TRAXSource.com.
Nice.
Angel here, what's up?
Bless up, y'all.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, we come to the part of the show where we get to hear our beautiful host do her segment. Y'all get ready for Suckers Need to Know.
Hey,
let's get it.
What's going on? It's your girl, Mona Lisa, with Suckers Need to Know Monday here live at Nocturne. Listen, I want to get right into it, okay? All right, Suckers Need to Know. Women and men, you got to stop seeking wise counsel from just anybody, okay? When it comes to relationships and then, first of all, of just who you are. I've been seeing a lot of people on Facebook, and not just even on Facebook, but just friends in general. You call and you have an advice about something. The only advice you need to know, first of all, is knowing who you are. Okay, that's the first and foremost thing. And I think a lot of people struggle with this on Suckers Need to Know that you calling people. I can't tell you if you want hot dogs or caviar, sweetie. I can't tell you that. You got to know what you like and what you want, because what I'm going to tell you is my opinion on something that I don't like. So, for example, I know for me, I had said to myself, I wanted to have a Coming to America wedding. I wanted to be with this type of guy. Now, what I knew about that was when I started dating around, I would bring it up to every guy I was dating to see where their mind was at. And they all was like, yeah, that's not going to be my type of wedding. So guess what I did? I crossed it off the list because I knew what I wanted. But then I met my husband, of course, and when I brought it to him, he was like, this is awesome. He gelled with me. He loved it. You got to know what you want. I had a lot of people that was like, no, 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 no. But it didn't stop me from going after what I want, and I knew what I want. People told me I was crazy. People told me all types of stuff. But the thing that they couldn't do was take what I know, and that's what I want, what I like, who I want to be with, why I want to be with them. I watched a show early on Facebook, and they was talking about this guy who was trying to tell this woman about who she is. She gave herself a 5, first of all, in this conversation piece, and she made 6 figures, and she wanted to have a 6-figure guy. There's nothing wrong with it. If you own Link and you want a 6-figure guy, there's nothing wrong with it. It's whatever you want. I think people don't understand, once you know what you want, whatever God says about you, when you know who you are, no one can tell you nothing. Nobody's opinion can defer you from what you're asking for. You want a king, you can get a king. If you want a prince, you can marry a prince. Let's look at all the things that has happened out here in the world. We looked at, we didn't have a black president. We didn't have a black vice president. All the things that didn't say, but they was determined. And they knew what they were going after, and that's why they're there. So my advice to you on Suckers Need to Know, when you in relationship, when you're trying to find out, if you don't know what you like, I can't help you. Okay? I cannot help you if you don't know what you like. And going around calling people, asking people to give you advice about relationships, they can't help you, because all they're going to do is put their opinions on you. You feel me, Jay?
Rrr.
You know what I'm saying? You can't go out here expecting me to tell you, hey, I'm not into big guys, you know, and there's nothing wrong with it. So if you tell me I'm into a big guy, I don't know what too much to say about it, because that's not my cup of tea. So I can almost deteriorate with you from going forth, because that's not my thing. So instead of talking to me, what you should have done was talk to yourself in the mirror, got yourself together, and knocked on the door and said, how you doing?
I want
a bear. I want a little smuggy bear. Okay.
Hey, come with it, dog.
Baby.
You got to speak
suckers
it.
Suckers need to know. You need to know who you are.
That's it.
Stop looking for advice for everybody. God already spoke and said your price is above rubies. He's already told you a queen, you a king. Walk in it. Don't worry about what Mona Lisa got to say, because what I got to say may not be just what you need to hear for that day.
Absolutely not.
You know what I'm saying? So,
She already told you.
Like, this is how it is. You know what I'm saying? Jay, what you got to say on this? Come in.
Yeah, that's real talk right there, man. You have to know what you want and speak it into existence and believe it. Like in detail, full detail. Like if you don't like something a certain way, or you're not attracted to, be 100% honest about
honest.
That. Period. Like,
and it's gonna come your way.
That's it. Then it's gonna come.
And no man can tell me how a man gonna come my way. No man can tell me what number I am. If I want to be a 10 today and a 5 tomorrow, that's what I feel for the day.
Sure.
And whatever day, if I feel like I'm a 5 today, you're gonna attract 5 men. Okay.
And with that being said, we go into our music spotlight. And what a song that's fitting. It's called Love Manifesto, Black Widow DJ Immaculate, for our music spotlight.
Come on, Jamahl.
Thank you for Suckers Need to Know.
Suckers Need to Know.
Every bruise, every scar, every heartache. depended on it. Love me like my heart holds the antidote to every ailment in your soul. Love. Love is an action, a verb, a responsibility. The act of placing another's heart inside your hands and guarding it fiercely. Freeing, healing, liberating. It's protection from life's cold. Warms the soul, refreshes the spirit, rejuvenates the mind. Love me. Love me authentically. I want to be loved like every day is our last, every moment our anniversary, every kiss just like the first. A love that doesn't hurt. I want to rise in love, freeing my soul, allowing my vulnerability to show without fear of rejection and judgment. Love me. Give your heart to me. This is my love manifesto.
Story, don't you? You want to hear the whole story.
Replay.
That is Black Widow.
Another, in my soul. I want to jump this table up and start just going crazy and beating the Steve speaker.
Man, another Chicago banger.
Yeah.
Chicago been doing some real, real hot house music during quarantine. For real. So shout out to the producers and the artists in Chicago. Mad love, y'all. Keep that heat coming.
And also, let's give it up for our producer, Francois.
He
got to put up with our shit every week.
And he stays so professional and calm. Yeah,
he does.
Just chilling.
Like, I will fight for him. You ain't finna take him away from us and go to another team.
Never.
You I just take me with you. You hear me?
We're going.
Listen, we had an NBC contract. It went to WBBW.
Right.
We lost that contract.
And then we went to
CAN. And we went to
CAN TV. And now
they refuse us.
Right.
So now we a Nocturne.
Right. They the only one that wanted to give us a chance around
Nocturne,
this.
Nocturne, open the door.
Open it up.
Open the door, and it's been the best decision of my life.
Y'all bless this club. Yes, indeed.
So
yes,
now
indeed.
We get to the part of our show. My man.
Yes.
Jamahl with Positive Vibes. Take it away, bro.
All right, what's up, y'all? I'm going to hit y'all with just a little bit of something to help you to feel good, because I know there's people out there going through some things. So we always going to go through things. It's not how we go through them. You know what I mean? We always have to try to remain positive. And I know it's hard sometimes. You just want to give up.
Yeah.
But the key is to never, ever, 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 ever give up. You keep pushing forward. You keep believing in yourself. And if people got something negative to say to you about you, don't listen to them, because that is not what you believe about yourself. And I know it's hard right now because a lot of people are lonely out there.
Yes.
But take a look at that man or woman in the mirror and imagine whatever it is you ever wanted to be, anything you ever dreamed, this is the time, is now. That's why everything had to stand still. So this is the time. We get ready to go into the fifth dimension, and then things are going to change. Remember, change comes when you change yourself, and when you believe in yourself, and when you love yourself.
Yeah.
These are the keys. How y'all feel about that?
I'm feeling that all the way. That's just like, you couldn't say it no better. Like, the loving yourself and the change, it comes within the renewing of the mind, believing. Like, no one can help you but yourself. The first thought of mind is that. And once you have that, you're unstoppable. I'm loving that.
Unstoppable. You can always fulfill your dreams if you truly believe and put in the work.
That's what's
up. So bless up, bless up, bless up. Be well.
My man, Jamahl.
Positive vibes.
You know what? It's been a great show, guys. Wow. It's over already.
No.
It's over. Man. I want to thank, of course, MonaLisa. Jamahl, thank you for being here.
Oh, for sure.
To our producer, Francois. Thank you, my friend.
Yes.
To all of you are watching us on Facebook, Twitch, Mixcloud, YouTube. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And share it with a friend.
If you care, share.
If you care, share.
We're going to be doing hot topics every week, you guys, so tune in.
And I want to see some of your comments, because I read the comments. I want to see what y'all talking about.
I like this. She got that New York accent.
What y'all talking about? I've been around the world,
She hit her with that dope accent.
What? Man, good night, y'all. Thank you.
Smashing diet has. How night?
You know what?
Give him his acting debut.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
Thank y'all for watching. This is House Talk. Until next week, we'll see you soon. Bye.